our development outcome tracking system has been an invaluable development in IFC's history. It has allowed us to look back and assess our development impact and to be able to communicate what have we achieved. I remember when I first started, it was all about volume and making an investment. And that was important at the time, making our first investment or our second in a sector in a very tough country. In my case, it was Ghana, Mali, Togo at the outset was terrific. That was what we were assessed by. But increasingly, it's about being able to articulate what are we trying to achieve, what's the impact, and that is what DOTS has allowed us to do. Now, to say that it's invaluable doesn't mean it was perfect or there isn't more that we can do. We continue to refine the system in terms of technical aspects, but also in terms of communicating what have we achieved. But also it's about using that to build on it and to look forward now. And it is the fact that we had the DOTS system that has allowed us to even think about what we're trying now to achieve, which is to drive our business through the IFC development goals. And these IDGs, I think, are a very important part of our future. It is about, in the end, the Holy Grail is about development impact per resource utilized. So we're nowhere near achieving that or getting to that Holy Grail, but it is, DOTS has been instrumental in getting us there. We're continuing to build on it. And I'm confident over the next year or so, as we pilot the IDGs, that we'll take it to the next level. So thanks again to all the team that has developed this, Roland and many others. Thank you, and we'll continue to build on what you've started so successfully.
We work closely with the IFC, and to the extent we can align the information request of the IFC with what we believe will be useful information to our commercial clients, there is huge value. If in doing that we can be ahead of other competitors or ahead of the industry in our development of key metrics which will come into place for those industries, that can have good commercial value.
What we are currently working on is using the information we are getting from DOTS in order to have more forward-looking goals for the corporation, the IFC development goals. In that way, we hope that development results and the development results we expect from our new business going forward are going to be more incorporated into the thinking of our operational people, in particular new business. This is one area where I think we can still do better, that we really have a stronger link between the new business, what we hope to achieve in terms of the development results, and then ultimately helping us to achieve better results. In that vein, at this point, one of the weaknesses that I still see in DOTS is in too many cases, we are going to our clients almost apologetically and saying, sorry, we have to ask you for this information. However, I really think that this development results information is something that could be a key competitive advantage for our clients also. For example, I've talked to lots of, say, financial intermediaries who are eager to show how their operations contribute to development results, or to mining companies that want to show how they are contributing to the economy. And if we get to a point where operational staff go to our clients saying that tracking development results, you're not just doing for us, but this is something that can develop into a competitive advantage for your own business, then we are in a much better place than we are today.
So IFC has come a really long way in terms of impact measurement. We've come from making a lot of ex-ante promises that we really couldn't say much about, to a way of really measuring impact that's whole and measurable and aggregatable. So I think for us it's really become an occasion to be able to make promises to the board that make sense, because previously the board really looked at our engagement in developing countries and would ask, okay, what is the tangibility of these impacts? Are we doing anything in infrastructure? Are we really helping SMEs and financial markets to advance in the countries where we operate? This process hasn't really been too dissimilar from IFC's engagement in emerging markets. If you look at the whole term emerging markets, that was coined in the early 80s. Emerging markets back then were seen as a very complicated and difficult markets to operate in, virtually a black box. This parallel in my mind is very similar in terms of development impact measurement. Previous to about the year 2005, no IFI was really measuring development impact. It was also seen as a black box, as something that not too many people knew too much about. So here IFC has really been in the vanguard of results measurement. So we've been able to tackle two very big issues by really rolling up our sleeves and thinking about things and how do we measure, how do we invest in these countries, what makes sense, what can we tell to the board. And then lastly, I'd like to say that the most important aspect of what we work is, again, this license to operate. What does the board think about what we do? Do we have tangible measurement results that make sense? And I think in the last 5 years, we've been able to say, you know, absolutely, we've had systems that have been very tedious to work, but like any organization, you're going to have all kinds of issues, all the way from measurement platforms to training, but I think we've been able to overcome those, and I think the systems we have in place now really make sense and are constantly getting better. This is not dissimilar from, say, inventing a computer chip or a transportation method where you know, you have constant improvements in the way that we do things. So I think the DOTS platform has come a long way, and I think it's going to become even better in the next 5 years. Thank you.
We feel very close to IFC because we also have our own measures. We also are trying to be very, very objective in that sense and learning a lot. That means that the IDGs that are defined by IFC are also, in the case of the financial ones, very close to what we really are trying to accomplish, and we're learning also in the process. This means that we have also a small responsibility for the IDGs of IFC. And also we are measuring not only the things that are good, but also the things that where we have to be better. And that means that any problematic situation can be arranged on time.
I always like to talk stories, because I think stories are the ones that we'll all remember from IFC from years to come. And this is a story of one that I actually went through, which kind of changed my view of looking at development impact and development indicators. And this has to do with some of our authorizing environment. We have to realize we're all owned by governments. We have a development mandate. But at the same time, we have a very strong culture of doing individual, very strong deals. And some may say that some of us like to be, in spirit, investment bankers. But I tell you, I was not too long ago, I had to represent that IFC needs to step up on certain investments, do more programmatic investments, and try to make a difference, try to have real development impact. To do that, we needed other people's money. And I had my doubts, frankly speaking. I had my doubts whether can we achieve what we wanted, can we achieve what we promised. But I never forget the day when, about a year later, I mean, yes, these were preliminary numbers, but we were looking at what indicators we had promised, how we were following it up, and I showed it to the deputy minister in charge of actually giving us the money. And it was very interesting because essentially he was not focusing at all whether the money was spent, but whether it was spent in the right way. And we had the numbers to back up what we did, and we had the numbers to show what we actually achieved in terms of what we were achieving in the IDA countries, what we were looking at the bottom of the pyramid, and so forth. And we actually had met all of the indicators. Now, you should have seen the smile on his face, in a sense of actually realizing and then going, turning around to his team and saying, this is what I'm going to show in the cabinets. And for me, it was a very interesting revelation in terms of the importance of development indicators, the way we're actually looking at it globally. And this is not something that comes to any one of us easy. And certainly, we have a lot of improvements to do. But it's a question of how do we actually use them? How can we convince our clients to use them? And how do we see value addition coming from it? And I think we see, not only in our authorizing environment, but we see some first, if I use the word green sprouts in the client base. For those who have not seen, but should actually read, Standard Chartered Bank was trying to emulate what we are trying to do with the development indicators in what is their impact in a country. It's not perfect, but this is, again, private sector slowly starting to look at the benefits of actually doing the right thing. And I think if I look at forward, I do look forward after five years when I'm already gone from here, but it would be my expectation is that we will have set up the standards that a lot of the industries are following up. And this is why actually I'm very, very proud of working for IFC that takes this type of initiative seriously and rolls them out.
5 years ago, for the first time, we were able to report from the Development Outcome Tracking System, or it's as it known, DOTS. Well, that actually followed a realization by management that the evaluation results, even though we had a very strong evaluation background in IFC, came too late in order to be as useful as they could be for management information. So I was asked to implement DOTS, and with the very strong support of management, which emphasized that this is really our core business and we have to be able to report on our development results, the system was introduced and allowed us to report first internally to the board 5 years ago, and then subsequently in 2007 in IFC's annual report also externally. This was really very unique what IFC achieved in that respect, because we were at that point the only multilateral development institution that was able to report on the current development results of its portfolio and to also have an external assurance provider review the quality of the data that we had. So this was a huge success and was very much recognized by internal and by external stakeholders. Since then, I have had more or less a steady stream of representatives of other development finance institutions who came in and wanted to learn about IFC's systems. And in many cases, they have actually then emulated what we are doing. For me, DOTS was the natural evolution from an exposed evaluation system to ongoing tracking. And where we are right now is with the introduction of the IFC development goals, we are trying to use this information for forward-looking corporate goals that can help to drive IFC's strategy. The reason results measurement and the development outcome tracking system is so important for IFC is because this is really IFC's core business. So IFC has also integrated that a lot into strategy and operations and also into incentives. So for example, once we have collected the information every year, there's an in-depth strategy cycle where development results information is being used to inform strategy. What should we do more of? What should we do less of? What should we do differently? So in that sense, DOTS really informs how we do our operations. It's also going into incentives because IFC has a corporate scorecard where one of the important components on development results is the DOT score for investments. This then cascades down into the departmental scorecards and ultimately also into individual performance incentives. So again, one area where IFC is quite unique is that we have a long-term performance award where people who have brought into IFC's portfolio the best performing deals in terms of their development results as well as their financial performance do get an award. This linking development results and incentives I consider extremely important because ultimately that drives the organization.